I don't care about anything.
Oh no, when you plugged in the camera?
What I didn't do was change the title of the stream.
I did.
Oh, you're thinking, Jack.
I'm
thinking.
So on top of it, Rich.
Hello, hello.
When you plugged in the camera, it moved the microphone audio down one, and so for some reason I thought the computer was reading our audio. Everybody, welcome. Welcome to the stream. A little bit earlier than what I said it would be, which is great.
Well, it's good. That's good. It's fine.
It's rather earlier.
People get to miss this action.
This amazing.
Which side is this? I don't know. One of these.
Amazing
sides.
Action.
One of these sides is the proper side. I think it's this side is the game.
Hold on, let me.
And this side is the end of the screen. I'm not sure.
We are starting a little bit earlier, so I'm gonna quickly tweet out that we are starting. Hold on. Pause for tweet, just because we're not starting exactly when we said.
How early are we?
I said 8-ish, but I said it might even be later because I wasn't sure when I was going to be here. So you know, a little bit earlier. We're going to hashtag it. We're going to hashtag it Duskers.
We'll probably play more Phoenix Wright, but doesn't mean we're going to barrel through the whole game at once. Take a breath. I did not watch Preacher. I don't care to until more episodes are out and I hear more.
I don't
have anywhere near enough faith that they're going to handle the source material right. Nowhere near enough faith. Ironically,
yeah.
I suppose, because, you know, that series is the atheist Bible right there. So what are you gonna say?
I recorded it.
Yep.
I recorded it, and I just have not cared to watch it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and tweet. And yes, I've seen all of. Have you seen all of the negativity coming out about the Warcraft movie? Oh,
was
people.
Was there ever positivity?
Well, there was nothing. There was nothing where they're like, oh, you know. A movie based on one of the largest video game franchises ever, you know.
Let's pretend I don't know anything about Warcraft.
Okay.
What don't people like?
Oh, they just say it's a bad movie.
That's all?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay.
They didn't get orcs right?
They didn't. No, I don't think the fans are beating it up. I think people say it's a bad movie.
Why are the female orcs like normal human sized?
Is that true?
Look like she was.
Because they still got to be sexy orcs. You know you got to make them sexy orcs, Rich.
That better be some tough vagina. Because that could just be devastating.
Well, they're orcs. They're stronger. Every part of their body is stronger, Rich.
All right, so what is this game?
I am super excited to have you play this game. It's Duskers. I don't even know if I can properly explain it to you. Here's what I can tell you. Hand me the manual. I printed out the manual and I put it in a nice dust sleeve,
mm-hmm.
because
mm-hmm.
I thought it was nice. So I printed that out. Here's what I will tell you from the manual for standard salvage vessel operation. Primary objective is to determine cause of termination of human civilization.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I'm just warning you.
Yeah.
I have been in full-on doom mode.
Absolutely.
So this is going to be like, this looks like this game is just going to be complete whiplash.
Yeah, it's gonna,
I might break my neck playing
this game. It is going
to
be a harsh downshift, which, by the way, is exactly what I needed after Doom. Like, I love Doom.
I just need more Doom.
I love Doom, but it's just like, you know, I need a game where I can just slow down and take my time.
Oh, I loaded up the Brutal Doom, got that going.
I'm sorry. So, here's what I will tell people is you are flying around in a spaceship,
uh-huh.
and it is your job to determine what happened to human civilization, but you cannot leave your spaceship.
Okay.
And so it is up to your drones. You have to control a fleet of drones to investigate other ships.
Okay.
And so why don't you go to...
Are we like the last remaining human or are we some alien?
We don't even know if we're a human, an alien, if we're alive, if we're a computer program. We don't know anything.
All right. All right. I'm hitting P for play game.
No, well, go to drone operator training.
Drone operator training. Okay.
I think that's important. Welcome to drone operator training.
Use arrow keys to pilot drone one. Oh, okay. Press two.
But now here's where it gets fun. Schematic view. Look at this little choice.
Currently, the derelict ship is unexplored. So you only see your ship's docking bay.
Mm-hmm.
Type A1, just A1, then enter to open airlock 1. Whoa, now press space to what?
So space toggles between
this view
and the view of one of your drones.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then the number corresponds to the drone.
To the drone, right.
Then I can choose to send a drone in here. All right. Yeah.
You found a power inlet. Notice how drone 2 up there has a... Oh, sorry. If you could switch to drone 2 for me. Drone 2 has a generator power.
Okay.
So why don't you pilot drone 2 over to that power inlet? And now here's the most wonderful thing. So now you have to type in commands into your little console. Generator. Isn't that fun?
You are easily amused.
I am. I really am, Rich. Okay, so
you can now operate. We should probably read this out loud.
You can now operate newly powered doors. However, never open doors to unknown rooms. Notice D4 is open. Type navigate 1 R3 to send drone 1 to room 3.
Can I just move there myself?
Well, you could.
Okay.
Or you can type in the sequence. And then he just automatically goes in there. Isn't that adorable?
That's adorable, yeah.
So now you can look around. So yeah, there's two, you can either... So now, this is the most wonderful thing about the game is, we are just controlling the drone. So we, and the drones don't have cameras or anything, they only have sensors. And so, we can only see, this is the only way we can see the ship is through the drone sensors. Okay, you found a fuel access port. Drone 1 has a gather upgrade. Type gather or GA, then space, tab, or enter to auto-complete the gather propulsion, All commands, have an auto-complete feature, which is really helpful later on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's see if room 4 is safe. Drone 1 has a motion sensor upgrade.
Mm-hmm.
Switch to schematic view and type motion, then enter. The red indicator in room 4 means badness is in there.
Mm.
Let's see if we can herd them out of room 4. First pilot drone 1 back to room 2. All right, so... It's cute.
It's adorable, Rich. Look at this.
Now let's try herding the enemy from room 4 to room 3. From the schematic view, use the motion sensor again. Type D4 to close door 4, then D5 to open door 5. Okay. Oh, and then D5
mm-hmm.
to get him in the room 3.
Is yeah, because we already cleared
yeah,
out
that
room
way we
three.
Can see 4 and 5.
Okay. So now close D5. And now he's locked in.
All right. All right. Eight.
You get it? He gets it? Can you play Doom on these drones?
Probably.
Maybe what we can imagine is after the Doom Slayer murders all of the demons, we are now picking up the pieces here. We are a demon ship looking for the rest of our demon friends.
It's now safe to open door 3 and explore the room on the other side.
Obviously, this is just the tutorial section. A destroyed drone. Drive up to it and type the command swap to loot its upgrades.
Okay.
And then escape to exit that little screen. Okay, let's see here. Looks like there's no more ship to explore. To leave, let's try a simple navigate command to simultaneously send both drones, 1 and 2, back to the docking bay. And so then you can type nav.
Help navigate. Type help navigate to learn how.
Oh, sure.
What does that say?
So something you can type that I do whenever a mission is over is I type nav.
Yeah.
All R1.
Okay.
So nav space, and then, you know, to autofill navigate, all, and then to R1.
So weird.
Isn't this...
So weird.
Isn't this incredibly interesting?
My brain is all shotguns, but yes, it's hard to judge right now.
I know. It's a downshift, and we're streaming. And yes, I'm wearing shorts. It's been kind of nice out. I'm wearing shorts. When it gets nice, I want Rich to try. I'll play later. I can play more later.
Exit. All right.
You are now ready, Rich. Oh, obviously, yeah, if you want to. There is some there's some graphical options. I've had to tweak some graphical options. I've been playing on my
keep it for now.
On my you also might want to change in the options menu or not.
Oh, what?
No, that's fine.
What do you want to change?
Well, we can change it later.
I can. What is it?
Well, let's just wait till we initialize, and I'll tell you. There's some difficulty things where it's like you can get more scrap or stuff like that,
okay.
Which we might want to mess with, but we'll see.
We'll try default and see what happens.
Absolutely. Okay, so here's the real thing. So it's up to us to investigate what happened to human civilization, but we are critically low on fuel.
Mm-hmm.
And so we need scrap and we need fuel to keep moving, to keep investigating.
So kind of like FTL.
Little like FTL. Little like FTL.
All right, fuel low, 6 days. Crew size 1.
That's us.
How lonely.
How lonely? We only us and our drones.
All right, so initiate emergency distress sequence. Sure, why not? Yeah, do that. Vessels detected, 4. Response received, 0. How depressing is this game, by the way?
It's very depressing. It's very lonely and depressing.
Oh, great. I just want to shoot, I just want to shoot things, run around. But now I have to be sad and depressed.
We can't just shotgun demons every day, all day.
And the last one left in the universe. Everyone's dead. That's art. Death is art.
Death is art.
Okay. Enter to continue. Sure, why not?
Oh, yeah, here it is. Summary of primary objectives. Gather intel logs from derelict spacecraft.
Okay.
Gather resources necessary for survival. Search for survivors. If objectives cannot be completed, recommended action, initiate a reset.
So that resets the whole game?
The whole game, yeah.
So it's like roguelike?
It's a roguelike.
Okay.
So now everything about this game is controlled through the keyboard. It'll cost you fuel to jump to any of those, but we are already on a ship.
Oh, is that not, okay, that's not the tutorial one?
That is not the tutorial one. Oh, yeah. Yonder. Interesting. An adjective. Arousing curiosity of interest. Holding or catching the attention. An interesting debate. Just kidding. This honestly looks interesting so far.
Yeah, it's interesting.
It's very different. And I saw someone made a video about this. Tommy Refanes? What's his name? The guy who was the programmer for Super Meat Boy has been tweeting about this for the past week, and it just got me very interested in it. Okay, so if you press D... Oh, well, and you already did the 1, 2, 3, the system, the galaxy, and the universe, which is neat. Press D. These are our drones.
They all go on every... Okay, yeah, we don't have them, but yeah.
We can have them. We can rename them if we feel like... We probably should rename them.
Yeah, why not?
Let's see here. Control R renames the drones.
Oh, was do we have the new the thing? Is that part of the Twatcher? What was it part of the name?
Oh yeah, well you have the Twatcher. I don't have the Twatcher.
I got the Twatcher. Right.
We have a randomizer, right? The Chatter Lottery.
Chatter Lottery. All right. Subs.
Sure.
Okay.
All right. Pick a random chatter.
Doop.
The winner is Sari-chan. Sari-chan Beefcake for the win with the randomizer. Boom. Sari-chan. Sari-chan, you will be drone one.
Okay.
All right, drone two.
What is it, control R?
Control R, yeah. Head over to that Twatcher.
Okay, pick a random.
Mario
42.
That's great. It makes picking so much easier.
Yeah.
Boom. Mario.
And every one, we'll do
one from everyone, subscribers and non-subscribers.
Oh, and mods. I don't know why I should have included mods in the first time.
You probably should have included mods.
Yeah, well, the shit happens, you know. Announce winner and chat.
Oh, sure. We could do that too.
Yeah, sure. Why not? Why not? We got the Jugga 93.
Announcing. Oh, Beefcake says announcing chat is not working.
Oh, it's a work in progress.
You know what, Beefcake? We still love it.
Yeah,
it's still great.
Yeah.
Jugga 93. So, also, if you felt like it, and you never do, but you know when you move your drones, you can type in their name instead of the number. Which is neat, but
for the drone. Oh, okay.
Yeah, but obviously just 1, 2, and 3. So we got Sari-chan, Mario, and Jugga, and then later you can get more upgrades and change all that stuff.
All right, I'm down with that.
Okay, so we press B to board.
What's ship config?
We get upgrades to our ship that we can.
Okay, derelict. Well, that doesn't sound good.
We are the derelict.
Oop. Oop. And what's modifications?
Modifications is the scrap we collect can go to upgrading our drones or our ship, or to creating upgrades.
Okay. Yeah. So enter, I'm assuming?
We'll press B to board.
Oh, B to board.
And then, you know, here we choose our drones. Obviously, we only have three now.
Yeah.
So now enter.
Okay.
Let's see. Begin communication. My name is Captain. Transmission I received was over 20 days ago, excluding automated relays. I'm overwriting this log in hopes that another survivor finds it here. It feels odd to type survivor, but I believe that's what we are. I'll be staying. You're out there. I'll be broadcasting on emergency 001.
I think that's an actual number.
Oh.
It doesn't matter.
Captain Gene Vogel!
All right. Enter to continue.
Okay, so here we go. Usually, and especially early on, there's nothing in the first room.
Yeah.
So you can feel pretty confident in that.
Well, is there any downside to using the motion? Like, do we use energy?
So motion, if you see, has 50 out of 50. So we only get 50. And the more you use it, the more it can break down.
Okay. So it's probably better just to open the damn door.
For especially now, like this first room.
I guess I have to walk somebody in there before I can.
You need to discover the room before you can send people in there.
Ooh, that one's open. Could there be bad things in there?
Usually, I found not. Anything open from the get-go, I have found that there are no bad guys. This could be the time.
All right.
Okay, seems like you got a couple of clean rooms in there.
So, I probably want to gather. Unless you just collect it by... Okay. So then we need a generator.
Mm-hmm.
What do we got? Who's got what? Oh my God, why is this green? Huh? They have different colors?
They have different scanners. Drones see different things.
All right, what are the...
different spectrums of light.
I'm assuming this will come into play?
Yeah, it does. Well, and really, it's all visual. Like, it's all, sometimes they can... Yeah, no, it doesn't, super matter, but it's great.
Okay.
It's just like they see different things. And like every once in a while, your drones will malfunction where their camera feed will or their sensor feed will shut off. And you won't be able to see anything from them. It's crazy. Okay, so Marimaru needs to stay near the generator in order to keep it powered.
Oh, so he needs to stay there.
Yeah. Yeah. Can the Neo Roombas take off their pants? What?
So it's a destroyed drone. It's no good to me.
Well, so now type in swap and see if it has any powers you can steal. It has a toe. Yeah, I might as well take it.
Would I want somebody else to have it? Or does it not matter?
Well, you might as well take it and just add it to your list of things that you could give
someone. We can swap them later, is what I'm getting at.
Yeah.
All right.
You just want all the powers. There you go. And then sometimes if they're not destroyed, you can tow them back and then, refurbish them.
No, these motion, I'm assuming that doesn't carry over. I mean, that doesn't reset after the ship. That's...
Right. You are correct. It's permanently gone.
Okay.
Title Ding Frong, what?
Ooh, but I can't see what's in R4. Well, there's probably something bad somewhere, right?
Sometimes there is, sometimes there's not.
I want to use this twice. Right. Seems like a waste.
Right. I don't want to use this twice.
He doesn't have a gather.
He doesn't have a gather, right. He has a... Every once in a while, he'll come across a ship that has a terminal, and then Jugga can... why don't you...
What?
Oh, yeah, never mind. You did it. Everything's fine.
So what are the bad things like?
Huh?
What are the bad things like? I'm going to take a chance.
Oh, we might have an empty ship here.
Ha!
Oh, ha! That was a gamble, Rich Evans. Hi, jerkwad.
Early on is when you want to do your gambling.
Sure.
All right, I think that's everything. I'm pretty sure that's everything.
Yeah, that's everything.
All right.
Small ship.
All right.
Great.
Hey.
Easy peas.
So docking bay always R1?
Yes.
Okay.
Docking bay is always R1.
What
beep, beep, beep. Isn't that adorable?
It's cute. It's cute.
It's just so interesting. Now, I don't know if you have to. I always close the bay door before I type exit, but...
Is there some kind of issue with my pants in the cam?
What's your pants aren't on the cam.
Is this, like, glowing and it looks like my pants are glowing? Someone's talking about my neon pants.
I don't know.
I can't see what this looks like on cam.
I don't think our pants are visible at the moment. But I'll take a look. How about that?
Yeah.
I think it's just they just want you to take your pants off is all I think.
Okay.
Which, you know, that's natural. No, they can't even see our pants. Maybe that's why, is because they can't see our pants. All they can see is waist up, and so they assume we're pantsless.
No idea what goes on in the chat sometimes. No idea. No idea. All right. So upgrade, edit a drone, Serration. Chin, I remember. 4 scrap collected. How much fuel do we get?
It might be, you know what? It might be a, that might be a preacher thing. The preacher people were talking about doing a no pants episode. Was that anything in the comic books?
No.
I thought I saw an article today about Preacher, about like them wanting to do a no-pants episode.
I have even less faith in the show now.
Yeah, okay.
A no-pants episode.
Okay, so the little number next to it is how many fuels it'll take you to get there.
Okay. Well, I guess we have to. I mean, what are we going to do? We gotta do what we gotta do.
Here's something that's neat. Yeah. Press O for objectives. I think we're covering that up in the chat, but that's all right.
Yeah.
So, you know, here's our log for primary objective 1 and 2, right? The neat thing about this is when you reset the game,
uh-huh.
It doesn't reset the logs. So even if you fail and have to start over, you keep all of the little story bits.
But that's part of the objective, right?
What?
Is to get all the logs?
It's just to figure out what happened, yeah.
Okay. So it's not really a roguelike, because your progress in a way is saved.
Hmm.
I don't know how I feel about that.
Hmm, interesting. I don't know. I haven't gotten far enough into it.
Okay.
I don't know. Preacher is on Amazon Video with the first episode free, if that's something.
I don't want to just watch one. Look, I prefer binge-watching shows. I don't want to watch just the one. Fuck that. I don't even have any faith in the show to begin with. I am convinced they're going to fuck up Preacher.
Oh.
Even if it's not bad, it's going to be something so different, the tie into Preacher won't matter.
Sure.
Is my what I think.
That might be. That might be true. That might be true, Rich.
Yeah.
Hmm. Okay, escape out of this.
Yeah, I'm bored, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Why don't you go over to 1, just arrow over to 1, and press down, and drop that tow loadout. So, yep.
Okay.
That way, you know, you don't need 2 drones with tow. And now you have a tow ready to go in case you get another drone, if we lose Jugga.
Might we need 2 tows? Is that ever a thing? Or is 1 always going to be enough?
I've found that 1 is always enough, for tow at least. Mm-hmm. Like for tow and for gather, usually it's slow enough paced. I know there are some ships that I went on where there seemed to be like a growing radiation infection, so we needed to do the ship fast.
Okay.
So, you know, maybe having 2 tows would be good, but I found in most scenarios, 1 tow is enough.
Okay.
Great.
All right, let's see what's on the ship. How do I do that again? Oh, my God.
Now you go. Enter. Let's see what's on the ship.
Oh, why do we know what's in that one room?
Sometimes we scan before, and it just gives us a little peek.
All right. Let's see. There's a lot of rooms.
I've never, Jerkwad, yeah, you are kind of lost in this game. So, you know, basically all we're doing is controlling these drones and searching ships. That's it. And the interface is the most interesting thing for me, where we have this little old school DOS console that we use to control our drones, and it's weirdly engaging to me every ship, even though like it's very purposefully distant, you know, like we can't really see what's going on. It looks like it's a mess, but who knows if it really is, you know.
It's great. That's what I want. It's great.
I can tell you're kind of in love.
I'm in love with the idea. I don't know if I'm in love with the game yet, if that makes any sense.
That makes sense.
I like it when I get outside of my comfort zone with a game, and I like it when a game kind of challenges, when it does something different. So, to me, this is just different enough where I'm just excited.
Oh, why are some doors blue and some green? Does that correspond to the color of the scanner?
Say that again.
Why are some doors blue and some green?
The green doors can be opened. The blue doors are not powered.
Okay. Okay, so that's why. Okay, all right.
When you turn the generator on, you know, now we see more rooms, and now those doors can be open.
So if I turn the generator off, everything will be locked then, unless it's open first.
Right, okay. And who knows what that other generator opens?
All right.
I did get a power up once called Pry, where a drone could pry open an unpowered door. How comfortable was I with firewood? I was very comfortable.
Oh, wait, what is this?
That's
another power thing. Yeah. All right. All right, that seems bad.
Yep, that's bad. Oh, God. Oh, maybe you trapped him.
I may have.
Oh, you lucky bastard. You trapped him.
Lucky or clever, Jack?
Huh? Oh, God. Yeah, but there was no way to know for sure whether he went down into that other room.
Well, then I back out and I close D9.
Oh, you know what? He might be functional, actually.
How do we figure these things out?
Escape and type info. Drone Wally. Yeah, he is still alive. So you can tow him back to our dock, and then we can use him later. Yeah, that's those were the exact noises I was making when I first was playing this game. Like, ee!
How do I drop it?
Just type toe again.
He's just good if he's in that room, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Once you leave, then he's yours.
Maybe I don't want to do that.
Oh, just in case you need to run away.
Yeah. What?
I was tense there. So now, if you want, you can type gather all, and he will automatically gather everything in the room.
Okay.
If there are more than one thing.
I'm assuming a drone can't be full, right?
Say again?
It can't be full?
No, no. He can gather all the things.
Okay. That's gathered?
That is gathered.
Okay. Mm.
He can't be full.
Oh, why not?
I like it. I like the way you put it.
Ooh, what does yellow mean?
Yellow is another possible dock.
Which means we could leave from that instead?
Yeah. Oh, nice. So don't open it up because obviously your spaceship isn't there yet and you will be sucked. Sucked out into the void of space.
That's not good.
No, but you can move your ship to that dock and then move them all there.
Could there be something else? Behind there, other than a dock? Or is yellow always a dock?
Yellow is always a dock.
All right.
But,
why bother with that? Okay.
Yeah, right now. But, you know, like later you might, be trapped over there and need that dock, or you can use that to, blow out any monsters. But then it also blows out any treasures that's in the room.
Oh, tab switches between. That's interesting. All right, so that just. Oh, good. I'm good then.
Yeah, you did it.
All right.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
I see someone in the chat said, as a colorblind person, this game might be nearly impossible. Yes.
Yeah, that seems like a weird thing that they wouldn't design that with this in mind.
A colorblind option?
Yeah. I'm assuming there's a colorblind option.
There's graphical tweaks. I don't know. We can check. Go to options.
Right.
Navigate all back first.
Was it R1? Is the dock always R1?
The dock is always R1, yep.
Why did the screen get off? Messed up.
Because sometimes, randomly, your drones just flip out.
Okay. Okay.
Because they're machines, like they do that. They just flip out sometimes.
This is neat.
Ooh. Like sometimes they get stuck, sometimes like their camera just shuts off. Boom. Okay, so now, why don't you head over to drone config?
Yeah.
And then we can rename Wally.
Right.
As you see, though, Wally is broken.
Okay.
Let's do an everyone again.
Everyone?
Yeah.
All right. Shadamfreud. Shadamfreud.
Shadam.
As opposed to Schadenfreude?
Schadenfreud.
How do you spell Schadenfreude?
I have no idea.
It is spelled differently, right? Am I nuts?
I do not know how to read or write.
Okay.
So you can, please do not ask me how to spell stuff.
We're going to shorten this to Shad.
Oh,
because,
did you?
Because sanity.
Huh? Oh, you're a Schadenfreude.
Yeah.
And that's Schadenfreude.
Shadam.
Shadam. Perfect.
Shadam. All right. So broken drone.
Well, you see that it says 0 out of 130. That's their health.
Okay. Okay.
And so hit escape and go to modifications.
Mm-hmm.
Can't use your mouse. It's all keyboard.
That's so weird.
I know. and if you go over to your go down to Shadam. You can repair. You only have 13 scrap to spend, but, you can repair.
And it only costs 1 to fix it, though?
To fix it by 10.
Oh. I don't know the economy of this game. What counts as a lot of scrap?
We have a fair amount. If Shadam has 10 out of 130, Shadam is functional.
Mm-hmm. All right, so how do I?
Enter. And why not enter again? Give him another one.
No. I think it's good.
Oh, okay. So now
we'll be cautious for now.
That's the stuff in your queue.
Uh-huh.
And now you press E for execute. So now we have four functioning drones. Very exciting.
All right.
Very, very exciting.
How do I get him?
What is it? Control left or right to move him into the...
Weird.
Yeah.
Weird.
You have to design a game only using a keyboard.
Was it part of some kind of challenge or something?
I don't know. I think they were just like, let's think outside the box. They were, you know, let's think about a game that could never ever work on a console. I think that was their goal. Okay. If it'll never work on a console,
you could find a way to get this to work on a console. Not that it would be half as, that's what I'm looking for, interesting.
No, you need the keyboard for this game. If this is ever ported over to a console would need a keyboard.
You just convert the typing into like a click command.
That would be the dumbest.
You could do it. I'm just saying you could do it.
You could do it, but that would ruin
the game.
It's
not console proof.
You need a keyboard to play it.
By the way, I saw someone in the comments for the Doom review calling me a PC elitist.
Well, because of your controller.
Is it elitist to prefer a different control scheme for shooters? Is it elitist to like keyboard and mouse so much more than a controller that I don't want to play a first-person shooter with a controller?
It's elitist to blame the controller for all of the woes of first-person shooting.
Yeah, well, I think that's... The controller has had an impact on the evolution of the shooter, is what I said.
I don't think it's the controller, though.
They design these things with consoles in mind.
I think it's the design.
I don't think that's elitist. I think that's just, here's the history.
I have my little tiny
You know, all they needed is a fucking firmware update, and I wouldn't mind playing a shooter on an Xbox One. Just USB mouse and a keyboard. There you go. That's all you fucking need.
They don't.
Too uncompetitive in the multiplayer.
They do have them now.
Multiplayers, you can't have a mouse in a multiplayer because the fucking controller users would be owned.
Of course
and
they would
be. And they'd be crying constantly.
Listen, there is nobody...
They're using the right tools for the job! That's not fair!
Nobody is arguing that a mouse isn't more precise than a controller. But you can't blame the controller.
I just felt like being an asshole right now.
PS4 does support mouse and keyboard. That's true, but locks out in-game use for exactly that reason. Really? I like my controller. All of the footage you saw was me playing Doom with a controller on the Xbox One. I'm perfectly proficient at playing Doom with a controller.
Okay.
Perfectly proficient. That's all right. Why can't my aim assist win for me? Listen, as a diehard controller user, aim assist is absolute bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Absolute bullshit. No one should ever use that. I turn it off immediately. It's 100%
sometimes
bullshit.
Sometimes they only let you pretend to turn it off, or you just turn it down, but it's always on in a lot of games. I've heard this.
That's bullshit.
Yeah, it's necessary. because you're using a poor tool for the job at hand.
Good for a controller,
and like a platformer or something. Yes, you can be very good with a controller, like a Batman game.
Pretty good.
Well, controller's excellent for an Arkham game. Do you have to aim? Nope. Nope.
I'm pretty good with the control. Yeah, pretty.
Jack thinks he's as good as a mouse and keyboard.
I did not say as good as a mouse and keyboard. I said I'm pretty good with the
control. Now I'm not trumpeting my own skills because, you know, I'm not multiplayer trained. I'm laid back about my shooters.
Right,
just
right.
I prefer that control scheme.
Mm-hmm.
But in general,
we need a 1v1 me versus Rich Doom multiplayer, me on a controller, Rich using mouse and keyboard.
Oh, wrong.
No, no, it's not what I want. Go back to one. Oh, doorknob power. All right. That makes sense. Interface. All right. Is there anything to gather? That's the power. Sorry, I'm just...
Oh, yeah, no. Take your time.
Talking and exploring. What's the chat saying?
You know what? Take your time, Rich. That's fine.
I was distracted with my rant.
They're saying they want to see a 1v1.
You versus me?
You versus me. Controller versus mouse and keyboard. Which, by the way, that is not an objective use of science at all. Like,
no, because I don't have multiplayer. Sure, I am probably terrible.
Right, right.
Versus anyone, controller or not. This isn't me tuning my own gaming skills horn.
Oh no, and a mouse is infinitely more precise than a controller. Infinitely. If you want to be the most accurate you can be, you use a mouse. Absolutely. I just prefer the feel of a controller. It's more comfortable for me.
That's fair.
Yeah.
I don't have anything against that.
Right. And so, you know, like, I've learned how to kind of, like, set up my aim and then juke left or right to, you know, get it perfect. And, you know, I figured out how to work within my limitations because it's more comfortable for me.
As a mouse and keyboard user,
yeah,
I am very insecure. And I get defensive. That's why I'm kind of an asshole about it sometimes.
You're insecure?
Yeah.
Why?
Because eventually desktops are going to go the way of the dodo. Everything's going to be a fucking tablet. Mouse and keyboard itself will be obsolete. And then all of your dedicated gaming platforms, you're going to be forced to use a fucking controller.
Well,
shooters will be dead to me.
It'll be the VR stuff like we saw earlier.
Maybe.
You know, where it's like this.
Yeah, because motion controls, those are always so fun.
And precise. They're always precise, too.
I'm dreading the day where they tell me, no, you have to use a controller. And they're going to act like I'm in love with the idea, too. Here's your controller!
Special.
You can play Doom 5 with your controller!
It's specially designed just for shooters. It has super aim assist.
It makes me sick, Jack.
All you have to do is walk into the room, and we'll just lock on to all the enemies for you. You can get all the demons, Rich.
It makes me physically ill.
You can get all the demons. You can shoot them. You press the shooty button.
It's gaming's dark future.
Okay. Ooh, nice. So we got...
Oh, these are all the things we can do.
Ship scan, defense, or survey.
So these are all good things.
These are all good things. Why don't you go to Big View?
Big View?
Sorry, I forget what it's called. That view. What is that called? I should know this. I've played this game before, but... So now why don't you try survey? Jack has made you so mad. Why have I made you so mad? I'm so sorry. Will someone explain what's going on? Yes, I'm so sorry. For anyone just joining us for Duskers, right now, Rich Evans and I are controlling drones. And these drones have to search ships for us, and each drone has a little power that they can do, and we have to use the little... Which way am I looking? If we're looking at the game this way, so there's that little console window down there. We have to type in everything we want the drones to do, and that's the game. I don't know if that is explained properly.
Civil War discussion. Here's my Civil War discussion.
Yeah. Oh, sure.
It didn't excite me too much. It was a movie film.
I finally got to see
it. And the people fought. That's everything I have to say about Civil War. I really don't have any super in-depth, interesting thoughts. And in fact, I no longer remember most of the film. It's a good Spider-Man, is what I came away with.
Great Spider-Man. By the way, all of his like endless talking during the fighting, I'm in love with that Spider-Man. I'm super excited for his Spider-Man movie. I watched your Half in the Bag.
Yeah.
Because I finally seen it, so I can watch it now. And something you said that was absolutely correct, which is this was two movies.
Mm-hmm.
This was Captain America, the Winter Soldier Part 2.
Yeah, which I would have been fine watching.
And the Avengers Civil War.
Yeah.
There is no... You could cut out half of this movie and it would still make a ton of sense. There is no reason to smush these two ideas together. It's a fine movie. I was entertained. I really like the action sequences. The action sequences had almost nothing to do with the story, unfortunately. The big fight at the airport was utterly meaningless.
Mm-hmm.
Utterly meaningless. And as you all know, I am a unapologetic.
Well, it wasn't meaningless. That was the reason people went to see the movie. But it was, you know.
Sorry. It was utterly meaningless outside of promotional materials.
It was the spectacle, and everything else was the pretense to get to the spectacle.
Yeah, but remember, like, do you remember the spectacle in the first Avengers movie of all the heroes coming together and how that was tightly woven into the story of the movie? Wouldn't that have been great? Wouldn't that have been great?
Will this ship scan, was that reveal enemies too?
No. No, it will not. But if you see in R5,
mm-hmm.
that little blue gun thing.
Yeah.
If you type in defense, it turns on all of the guns.
Will that shoot at me?
It will if you're in the room. The gun is stationary.
Okay.
And you can always turn it off.
I still don't know what enemies actually do once they see you. Killed one enemy.
So defense okay. in room R5 killed one enemy. And now it's off. There you go. Nice.
So R5 is probably safe.
Probably, yeah. I think they, going back to Civil War, I'll try to be spoiler-free for anyone, but I think the way that they handled both Captain America's and Iron Man's argument for and against the Sarkovia Accord,
mm-hmm.
it, they each had one line of dialogue to give their side of the argument. And then it's like, I guess we hate each other now.
Oh, so teleport just moves him to a random way, like, do you have to pick where it goes?
Actually, you know what? I've never used the teleport. Probably pick a room, yeah.
Oh!
And you're there.
Isn't that neat?
That is neat. Oh, look, you can kind of see, like, the dead body.
Dead body? Oh.
Like, look right there.
Oh, from the...
From the whatever was in there. I don't think Civil War was boring. The action sequences were fun. And, like, each half of the story, you know, each individual movie, because there's two movies in the movie, was interesting on its own, but then they kept jumping back and forth. All right, now this is the section in which we care about the Winter Soldier again. Remember his best friend, Bucky? God, I don't care about Bucky. I also just don't give a shit about the Winter Soldier, you know? That's the other problem. Now this is the part of the movie where they hate each other. But, yeah, so I just...
It's not particularly fun seeing all these characters we like hating each other, no. It's not particularly fun.
It would have been okay had,
Yellow is a drone I can tow?
No, yellow is, scan is inconclusive to whether or not there is an enemy in there.
Oh, great. There's something going between R8 and
R7. Yeah. And you can't control that door yet.
All right.
Absolutely, Tiberius Kirk. The Winter Soldier, Tiberius Kirk says, the Winter Soldier has been at the center of two movies, and they've done jack shit with the character. Minimal backstory, minimal personal meaning. Absolutely. We are supposed to be so locked on to Captain America...
Yeah.
That we just feel for his best friend, where it's like that whole movie, it was just like, fucking kill the Winter Soldier already, because I don't give a shit about him. Or lock him in jail. I don't care. Do something with him to get him out of this movie.
Oh.
Yep. Gotta keep your generator near the generator. But. Yeah, I also hate his hair. I hate his hair. I think it's dumb.
Lure.
Lure, yeah. You can place a lure in a room with an enemy, and then it'll, you know, the enemy will be drawn to it, and then it'll beep when the enemy grabs it.
A room near an enemy.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, overall, I still liked it. It's a fine movie. It's good. But I feel like this is something I was telling you earlier, which is I feel like it is the most comic booky movie in the Marvel Cinematic Universe so far, and I think that's a bad thing. There's so much shoved in there, and that doesn't work for a movie. They needed to simplify. This needed to be two movies. But I still liked it. You know?
Oh.
Oh, yeah. See, if you... like,
it I was right. I had the door pre-typed in case I had to make a hasty retreat.
Right. And it doesn't accept typos. Let's see here. It's destroyed. You can't...
So it's just dead.
Yeah, okay. But you can swap and see if he's got anything.
What do you got? Shield. Ooh.
Shield. Ooh. And a sensor. Nice.
What does sensor do?
I don't know. Oh, wait. Does it tell you? Press down. Drops a sensor which continually scans a room for threats. Could be nice. No, and I'm a huge Marvel fanboy. And... like, I'm not disappointed. Maybe I'm disappointed. I don't know. Spider-Man's in it. Why is Spider-Man in it? There's no reason for Spider-Man to be in it.
No reason.
No reason for Ant-Man to be in it. Like, this could have... They're getting... I don't know what it is about Hollywood blockbusters where they feel a need. They feel a need for escalation. And I think that's what damaged this movie for me is, you just get a shield. Look, it's just like always on.
Apparently.
Oh, that's neat. Is I feel like this was a movie where like we have to add more. It needs to be bigger. It needs to be better. And it's like we're okay with just simple stories and good action.
All right.
I don't see why people said it wasn't fun just because it was dramatic. No, it was still fun. It was still a good movie. It's no Winter Soldier. Actually, last night, Lisa and I were about to watch Preacher. And, you know, we turned on the TV to watch the recorded episode of Preacher.
Yeah.
And Winter Soldier was on. And we just kept watching it because Winter Soldier is an amazing movie. Age of Ultron equals bad weekend civil war equals friendly skirmish at airport. Won't be an origin. No, upcoming Spider-Man movie will not be an origin story. They have already said that it's Spider-Man Homecoming, and it is now Marvel Cinematic Universe. So that right there was the Spider-Man origin story. We don't need an origin story anymore, which is awesome for Spider-Man fans. That's right. Bucky is a MacGuffin yonder, and there is no reason that this movie should have been hanging on his very life. What'd you do?
I'm hoping that guy wanders into R5.
Ooh, yeah, good idea. Good idea. No, Ant-Man was not the weakest thing in the movie. The movie was the weakest thing in the movie. Like, the fight in... The airport fight was a fun fight. Oh. Defense in room R5 killed one enemy.
Oh, good.
Boom. Tips not working? Tips not working? I'm very sorry.
Oh, shit!
Oh, you forgot to turn off... Oh...
So I'm dead now.
Well, you're disabled, so we can tow you back, hopefully. Who's your interface guy? There he is. No, wait.
What?
Oh, yeah. Never mind. You did it. Sorry. You got it.
Who's got the toe? You got the toe. Who's got the toe?
What's the, here? Here's not to. I know you guys are trolling me about Iron Man 3, which I consider to be a perfect action movie. I consider Iron Man 3 a perfect action movie because every action sequence adds to the story or the characterization. And the same cannot be said about Civil War. You can completely remove all of those action sequences, and the only thing that will change is we won't know how people got from point A to point B. You know? In Iron Man 3, if you take away action sequences, you are removing vital pieces of characterization. In Civil War, the action sequences only serve a purpose of getting a character from point A to point B, except for the last fight. No spoilers. So, it was fine. I'll see it again when it comes to video on demand. Like, when it comes to Netflix. I won't go to the movie theater to see it again. Just to see if, like, I missed something. But I just think it's cluttered. It's just too cluttered. And really, I don't think they could make two movies because there's only so much makeup they can put on Chris Evans to make him still look young. He's getting up there.
How old is he?
Chris Evans?
Yeah.
Who knows? Don't you feel like he has so much makeup on in those movies?
No, I don't feel like that.
I see every one of his movies. I feel like he has makeup caked on him. Maybe that's just how he looks. But but that's how I feel about Chris Evans.
You want aging? Robert Downey Jr. He's the one that's getting older.
Oh, sure. Agreed. El Argentino. Overall, I liked the movie. Because I'm a horrible Marvel fanboy. I think if I wasn't a horrible Marvel fanboy, I'd be a lot harder on it.
All right, I think I've got everything.
You guys don't see... It doesn't look like Chris Evans has so much makeup on in the movie. What is that? Oh, okay. Oh, you can pick up those scraps.
Wait. Which scraps?
Sometimes when you kill the bad guys, they drop scraps. I don't know what that means, Jabronski. I don't know what that word means. I'm sorry. Pure what? It's fun for the fight scenes. I wish it was more focused. I really, really wish that it was more focused. And now I'm very excited about Spider-Man. I want to see more of that Spider-Man. I want to see him do his swingy stuff.
All right, how do I repair again?
Escape.
Swap. Escape.
Escape. Modifications.
Oh, modifications. Bink.
Poor Sari-chan. I'm going to sneeze.
It's my fault. I was dumb.
Pardon me. Like, also Black Panther's involvement in that movie. I'm not sure what he's doing there. And it's just,
he's trying to kill Bucky. I know what he's doing there. He's driving the kill Bucky plot.
He's driving the kill Bucky. Well, oh, sure, you're right. He's in Winter Soldier 2. He's not in Avengers Civil War. He's in Winter Soldier 2. You're right.
Are you saying the movie should have been more fully about the debate about the law rather than Gotta Save Bucky? And that's what makes it two movies.
It's two movies. Yeah. There's the Gotta Save Bucky movie, which, sure, that has Black Panther in it. Yeah, absolutely.
Cap could have easily have tried to work within the bounds of a law to save Bucky, a law that makes perfect sense to me. Not everybody can run around blowing up buildings. That's not American. I guess technically, depending on who you
ask,
that's
very un-American. The law doesn't make sense because you can't have people dictating. You can't have committees dictating when these people can save people's lives. The Avengers save as many people as they can. To me, the most frustrating part about the entire thing was the Secretary of State or whoever, the mustache man, mm-hmm. was like, New York, and he shows like the devastation. And then he's like, oh, Sokovia. All I wanted was for Captain America to go, yeah, you remember when we saved the fucking world? Oh, I'm sorry. We killed a few people in Sokovia. Do you remember when we saved the fucking world?
Do you think that whatever governing body regulates this thing wouldn't say, yeah, save New York if the Superhero Registration Act were a law during the Avengers, the first one? You don't think somebody would have said, yeah, you're in, kids.
Yeah. Oh, but
go do your job.
But how long would it take? How long would it take them to get there? How many more of those giant worms would have come through? I'm not saying that they need no oversight. I'm saying that the paperwork was not the solution. Do you remember that one time we saved the world from Hydra? Fucking hell.
Can you, Jack, just go over to Russia?
Yeah.
And then just start, like, shooting, like, at a whole bunch of criminals. You're going to shoot grenades at criminals in the middle of a busy street.
Right.
Is that okay?
No, of course not. But we live...
The Superhero Registration Act is for that! That's what it does! That's what it prevents! And that's exactly what the Avengers did in the opening of Civil War. They're fighting with a band of mercenaries in a foreign country. They're not citizens of that country.
But they're not shooting
grenades. And civilians got killed.
They weren't shooting grenades, though. They were blocking
grenades.
They
certainly created a situation where people could have gotten hurt, and did.
They were also protecting everyone from a deadly biological weapon.
Do you know that being a vigilante already is a crime?
Yes.
It's already a crime.
Of course. So why do you need more? Why do you need more governing bodies? Oh, right, because they saved the fucking planet.
You want somebody responsible in charge of the nuclear launch codes, not anybody who just wants to fire a nuclear missile.
No, but we're talking about people who are nuclear missiles.
Yes!
Yes. Who, by the way...
Yes!
Who, by the way... have saved the planet four times?
Maybe not in the future. Maybe next time they accidentally blow it up.
Sure, absolutely. Or it gets blown up on its own. You need a governing body. You need a leader. But it can't be by committee. You can't have any red tape when people's lives are at stake in this fictional universe. Yep.
What I have to say about Civil War, I mean, you can apply this to the comic book Civil War. This doesn't have anything to do with the movie itself.
Yeah.
This is I don't know, what would you call this? It's not why the movie wasn't exciting to me.
Yeah. Wait, what?
What we're talking about now as far as the debate.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
No, but by the way, this debate that we are having, they never had in the movie.
No.
They each got one line. This debate I wanted in the movie, in Avengers Civil War, this debate would have been bigger, broader. Maybe we would have seen some examples of it going one way or another to get both sides of it so people could actually choose their sides instead of having to go off on the Bucky adventure.
I thought I fixed that drum.
You did not.
I'm pretty sure I did.
Remember, after you put it in the queue, you have to execute.
I thought I did. thought I did.
Oh.
Now I definitely did.
Now you definitely did.
Why are these yellow?
Should this have been a court? It should not have been a courtroom drama, obviously. But it should.
Yeah, that probably would have been too interesting.
In a more focused movie, in the Avengers Civil War, we could have had some action sequences that highlight the pros and cons of the Sarkovia Accord. And then we would have had some interesting discussions, some morality tales, some non, it's not just black or white, it's gray. And that would have made for a more focused movie.
How do I swap power?
Chris Evans is shirtless in all of the Captain America movies. It doesn't matter. You can get issue a GQ. I'm sure he's shirtless on that. I'm not he's a good, you know, good looking man, but Thor is ragnarking. He's ragnarking, Rich.
What?
Ragnarking. Thor is going on a super smashy buddy adventure with the Hulk for Ragnarok.
When is that?
Who knows? Next year? This year?
I don't know. What else is coming out this year? Are the summer movies done?
Doctor Strange. Is that fall? Doctor Strange is coming out.
Is that it?
Ghostbusters?
Oh, please.
Summer movie?
It's something to look forward to.
Oh, something to look forward to. Oh, God. No. You still got to see The Nice Guys. I hear that's a pretty good movie.
Kind of a lame summer of the Ninja Turtles. Oh, that movie.
Get out of here, Tardcore.
I like the Ninja Turtles.
Yeah.
But that movie is just genetically engineered for me to not be interested in it.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't like Michael Bay.
Yeah.
I don't like his take on the douche turtles.
Yeah, the dude bro turtles.
The douche turtles.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't like the cartoon that they're taking some of the elements from.
No, they take none of the elements.
I don't
from the
care much for Krang. I hate Bebop and Rock. Bebop and Rocksteady.
Beboop.
I hate them. They're stupid. They are stupid. I have no respect for a villain that is so horribly incompetent.
Sure. Okay.
Respect for that.
I can see that.
They're no threat to anything.
Bebop and Rocksteady. Yeah. Well, you know, they're a threat to innocent civilians because they just fuck around.
Maybe they'll be competent in the movie, but I still don't like the cartoon versions of them that they're based I'm not like excited about seeing them in the big screen.
They look ugly.
If you want to make me not be excited for a movie based on a franchise I kind of love, do what they're doing for the Ninja Turtles sequel. Do that. That's how you get me to not care.
Well, there's the new Star Trek. Don't care about that.
You mean the dumb action movie that's got a Star Trek name on it?
Yep. There's
is that this year? Is that this summer?
That's coming up. There's
Finding Dory. All right.
There's Finding Dory.
Yeah. We got Finding Dory.
There we go.
That's what we got.
Is that all we have to look forward to is Finding Dory?
Rich is not smart enough to understand Bebop and Rocksteady. please explain it to me.
Well, you see, it's a commentary on how the heroes turn into the thing they hate the most. And how villains are actually misunderstood. It's a modern Aesop's fable.
Of course, there's X-Men, but who gives a fuck about X-Men? Nobody, and I repeat, nobody liked Days of Future Past. Ever, I know people liked it. It looks dumb. It's getting terrible reviews already. Bryan Singer doesn't know how to direct action, so you can't even look forward to that. Aesop Rocksteady? Absolutely. None shall pass. Ay, ay, ay. Neighbors 2 does look funny. You know what we have to look forward to in the summer season? Mike and Dave Need Wedding Dates. Look it up. Written by the Neighbors guys. I have not listened to The Impossible Kid yet. I'm going to get that album as soon as I get home.
The Impossible Kid?
New A$AP Rock album. A$AP Rock, the greatest rapper ever to exist. The greatest rapper ever to exist. Not true. He is the most verbose rapper. Someone calculated which rapper has the largest vocabulary. You know, taking all. Oh,
was that active?
Yeah, I think.
How can you tell?
It might be coming for you. Yeah, there. It was just moving towards you.
I thought it was a turret.
Oh, okay. No, it was turrets don't show up as colors. Enemies show up as colors.
Oh, that's going to be a problem.
Yeah. That's right. A$AP Rock had a bigger vocabulary than Shakespeare. They took all the rappers' lyrics and tried to find who had the most unique words, who used the most different words, and A$AP Rock was far and ahead of any other rapper. A while back, you recommended the book Wool. Do I think it would make a good movie? Maybe. Maybe.
We found some things here.
Oh, okay.
What is this?
Items found. Ship defense controlled via ship access terminal. Ship upgrade remote power used. Oh, great. So
what is all of this?
Okay, great. Ship access terminal. Okay, so the ship upgrade is something that you can tow back to your ship.
Mm-hmm.
And remote power is great. It can power one of those generators.
Okay.
So you want to tow that back to your dock.
Oh, so is there two things?
Control ship. Access terminals.
Ship power. Remote power and...
Remote
ship,
power.
Ship defense. Yeah. What is ship defense?
I don't know. Go back. Once you drop this off, head back there and see what that is. Like, Wool is a lot. I think Wool, I'm going to go ahead and agree with Moki that Wool would need to be a miniseries, not a movie.
Ship defense.
Controlled. Oh, the ship defense is the turret up there.
Oh, well, if I turn that on in here, I'll just be dead.
Oh, yeah, but you can only turn it on with a terminal. But basically, when you typed in info, it was just telling you all the things in the room. Not the things that were right in front of you.
Oh, well, what the hell is this then?
That was where the upgrade was.
Why is there still a thing there?
To tell you where it was.
Why do I need to know where it was? That's just going to confuse me. As it did, quite successfully.
Touché. Oh, so the alien is in our, or whatever it is in R5, but the gun is in R4. And the terminal is in R5 to control the gun in R4. So you have to try to see if you can get it in R4.
Well, how do we know it's in R5? Oh, because it's the icon there.
Isn't that where you were? Didn't you look?
I'm in R4.
Right, but
I looked in R3.
Yeah, R3 is clear, but didn't you look into R5 and there was an alien, or was that a ship ago?
No, this is an alien in R5 now. So
yeah.
I'm going to get it out of R5 so I can... Oh, why all this shit? All right.
If you can get it into R4, though, you can kill it, you know.
Well, I can use a lure, but I only got 6 of those.
You can replenish them with scrap, I believe.
All right. Who's got that?
Shadam.
Now I can drop that in here, right? And he will just he'll come to it.
Maybe. Yeah, I think he will. Do you want to drop it there? Or do you want to drop it in R4?
You know, that's a much better idea. So anything else interesting going on in the chat?
I'm watching right now. They're trying to. The chat is currently trying to bait us to talk about the new Ghostbusters movie, which isn't going to work.
What? It's just not going to work. It looks like a lame comedy.
Of course.
And everyone's going to
criticize
it, and they're going to be labeled as sexist.
This is what they wanted.
What's wrong with talking about it?
Because, once again, a small minority of the people will label people sexist who talk bad about the movie. Those people don't matter. The people who label anyone else as sexist. There will be some people, I think, who will just review the movie as a movie, and everything will be fine.
I'm convinced that the angry video game nerd tried to sidestep the whole issue by saying he wasn't going to review it because, you know, he didn't want to give him money. But he just didn't want to deal with the sexism bullshit, and it just completely backfired on him.
Absolutely.
That's what I think happened there.
Absolutely.
Do you agree?
Oh, yeah. I think he just wanted to not deal with the. He's still in there.
So much for that lure.
Well, give him a little bit. And he's moving around. There you go. Oh. Nice.
All right.
And that's the thing. There is a remote and very tiny possibility, Rich, that the new movie will be funny.
Will it be better than Ghostbusters?
Doesn't matter.
It matters.
Doesn't matter.
It matters because here's the thing.
Yeah.
Here's the thing, all right?
Yeah, yeah. I'm with you.
If the movie's okay,
yeah.
It's okay. They just shot themselves in the foot.
Let's say the movie's funny. Let's go out on a limb here. Before let's just say, not just okay. Not just say it's a comedy movie. Let's say it's a funny movie.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then what?
All right. By calling the movie Ghostbusters,
yeah,
they have invited comparisons.
Absolutely.
They sent out RSVPs, please compare us to Ghostbusters.
You all remember that old Ghostbusters movie. This is like Ghostbusters.
And even if it's good, it's going to be, let's say it's averagely good, it's going to be shit in comparison to the movie that they are inviting comparisons to. Now,
yes.
On the other hand, if they had just made a unique franchise, some kind of supernatural paranormal comedy with an all-female cast, called it something else, oh yeah, it was pretty good, is what people would have said.
Absolutely.
Now people are going to say, if it's the same quality, they're going to say, no Ghostbusters. Why do they call it Ghostbusters? Now they're going to get more ticket sales this way, and that's all they care about.
Right.
But as far as perception, they've shot themselves in the foot.
I mean, you're absolutely right.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right. Defense in room R4 kills women. Great. Great. I'm just saying, there is a possibility. Obviously, the trailer looks bad. The jokes in the trailer don't work. But there is a remote and tiny possibility that the movie could be funny. There are talented people involved in the making of the movie.
Yeah, but they've invited comparisons to an all-time great classic.
Absolutely.
Which is a huge mistake.
And by the way, even if it was a cast of hot male comedians...
I'm sure I am on audio record somewhere.
Yeah.
Back when I thought it was going to be like Seth Rogen and friends.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, don't do it. I hope they don't do it. It's gonna be Seth Rogen or it's going to be, you know, whoever.
That's exactly who it would be.
Yeah.
It'd be Seth Rogen, James Franco... who's the tiny Seth Rogen?
Ant-Man.
Not Ant-Man.
Paul Rudd.
Who's the one that was in the Scorsese movie? And in 21 Jump Street and in Superbad.
Oh, I don't...
What's
I don't,
his name?
I don't know names.
He's like a tiny Seth Rogen. Who is that? What's his name? Chat. I
I mean, Paul Rudd would. Jonah Hill. Oh, thank you. Jesus. Yeah, it would be Jonah Hill. Maybe Paul Rudd.
Oh, I swapped the wrong one out. What? God damn it.
What'd you do?
I did dumb.
You did?
Of course, John Hamm would be in it somewhere. Maybe he would be the bad guy. But that's the point. The point is, like, what Rich is saying is correct. Even if it was a male cast, and even if it's funny, it's being compared. Did you forget to turn off the defense again? I'm so sorry, Rich.
It's okay.
I'm so sorry.
Shit happens, Jack.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Is he still on interface? Oh.
Sony announced there will be an all-male Ghostbusters reboot as well. That'll never get off the ground. Or they'll hold it off for a few years after the one they're working on now bombs.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You can't do that right away.
Yeah. It just means we're double fucked, is what all that means.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, what do we do here now, Rich? I gotta clean up your mess.
Yeah, I know.
All right, hold on. Navigate 3, 2, R.
I've right side. I'll probably learn to turn the defenses off in the future.
It's really helpful. Oh, he died in the doorway, not in a...
Did you read this one from yonder him?
Yeah, and someone says our tips are broken. It's not us, it's PayPal. That happens every once in a while where tips don't work. Sorry if you want a tip.
But there is an issue.
Huh?
There is an issue.
That's what someone said. They tried to tip and it didn't work.
Well, gosh darn it.
Oh, we're very sorry. But, you know, just if you at previously recorded in the chat, it shows up in red for us, so we are more likely to see that. If you have a direct question for us, oh, you killed the one with I guess I can always swap.
Swap, yeah. Dead or just injured?
It might be dead. Oh, disabled. No, it's fine.
All right.
If you're able to tow it, it's still salvageable.
Sari-chan is salvageable.
Sari-chan is salvageable. Okay, so what do I want to do here? We're gonna go exploring.
I was the one who posted that polygon video because I thought it was amusing.
Yeah, I thought it was funny. I don't, like, know the full context, but it seemed funny. Whoa. Do you have Gather? Who is Gather? Sari-chan. Damn it. It's okay. I don't need... We got a swap. Check. Jack-a-lag.
What do I think about the Matrix sequels? I don't.
Wow. You don't think about them at all?
Ethan Maid says, I sent this as a tip. Hi, you guys. Mentioned a crowd being silent, maybe due to pass-through being more sane. No, it's something else. That's all I can say. Also, how will RLM see Breen Lesson Number 4? DVD or theater? Tyron Sand says, my tip, I guess, didn't go through. The actor who plays Bucky is just not interesting or particularly sympathetic.
He's not.
Yeah.
You know what? He works great in The Winter Soldier because we only get him for like 2 minutes at the end. You only have to deal with him as an actor for 2 minutes at the end.
I guess you just need to see a bit more human through peek out every now and then through brainwashed machine.
You know.
Is that a writing problem or an acting problem? Is the question.
I think as an actor, he's not terribly expressive. Yeah. What it probably is a director problem.
Could as an actor, could he have found some way to like have the ghost of the machine peek out every now and then?
there's programming to be a murderous psychopath.
But I don't blame him as an actor. I don't think the director had a clear vision for him.
Okay.
I don't think the Russo brothers knew how to handle his character. And so he's nothing in Civil War, which I think is his big problem. Okay, let's peek into D12 here. Ooh, Ethan. Is there a bad guy? There is not. Ooh, oh, crap. Another door open. Is there a bad guy? There is not. We win the lottery. Oh. Yee. Ethan, guess what? You coming with us. Right.
The SoundCloud for the latest review, the new show.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be pretty common for review. I don't think there are immediate plans to do that for our other stuff, though.
For review.
The new thing they did about Tremors?
Yeah.
Did you watch that?
I did.
Yeah, there's a longer version on SoundCloud.
Oh, really?
It's just audio, yeah.
Oh, I missed that. I missed that part. That's a good idea. I know people like that. Oh, hey, now tips are working.
Hey, there we go.
There we go.
Anonymous says, hey, Rich. Hey, Jack.
Hi.
Do you know what's better than a mouse and keyboard or a controller? A lightsaber.
I mean, thanks, Anonymous.
Lightsabers are fine. They're not worth drooling over, but they're fine.
Excuse me. All right. Where do we got to go here? So we go navigate. Navigate 4 to R7. And then... D12 after you get through, and then we navigate 2 to R3 semicolon generator. I can multitask. I know how.
Oh my god, chat scrolls so fast sometimes.
Yeah,
we have too many fans. Why don't half of you go away so I can read these comments? Sharon,
man of the people, Rich Evans.
Sharon says, you think they're going to utilize the give Captain America a boyfriend trend on Twitter and make him bi? I'm okay with it as long as people lose their shit about it.
Of course it'll trend on Twitter. Of course people lose their shit about it. And of course nothing will happen.
Yeah, they're not going to do anything with that officially, no.
They still haven't figured out how to just give him a girlfriend. They haven't figured out how to do anything with him.
All right, let's see. Well, he had a girlfriend in the first one.
Peggy?
Yeah, Peggy Carter.
Peggy Carter.
But they're saying make him bi.
Probably not going to happen.
The problem with that is Bucky isn't very interesting. So you're giving him a lame love interest.
Bucky's not a love interest. They knew each other since they were kids.
That's not this whole thing.
It'd be Falcon. It'd be Falcon.
They want him. No, I think they're trying to pair him up with Bucky.
You think?
Because he's got such a hard on for Bucky and saving Bucky. He really does.
Bucky looked after him after his parents.
Sure,
he's a best friend. You go for Sam.
You hook up with your best friend. That's you want a happy marriage. You hook up with your best friend.
Yeah, but these are the movies.
I'm saying the studio's never going to do it, though.
Oh, God.
You hold your breath all you want. Nope, it's not going to happen.
Sure, no. Make a trend on Twitter. Make it a whole big thing. Nothing's going to happen.
Not that they did much with Captain America as a character in Civil War and his personal life, but the nice thing about Winter Soldier, right? It was the whole 1930s man out of time in an age he doesn't understand. And you want stereotypical 1930s straight white male for that bit to work.
Mm-hmm.
So for that reason... I don't know about by Captain America. Just so you can play up the man out of time, the traditional stereotype 1930s guy. He doesn't get rock music. He likes listening to old radio broadcasts.
Sure, sure.
And he's also bisexual. It's weird then. It's too much. Not that there weren't bisexuals in the 1930s.
Sure.
But
that wasn't a well known thing. What you want to do is you want to give him a partner. Mm-hmm. Who is bisexual or gay?
Yes, yes.
You want to give him someone to play off.
And then how he's how that would make him uncomfortable.
And see, I don't think it would make him uncomfortable.
Well, it would.
Huh?
It would.
I
if he were really a man from the 1930s, that would so make him uncomfortable. He's a decent human being.
I was gonna say
he could learn to deal with it.
I think they dealt with this in the comics.
Yeah.
I want to say I'm remembering a specific panel where there's like a gay someone or something, and Captain America said, "Who gives a you know? It's un-American to hate on your fellow brothers and sisters or whatever." I want to say they dealt with this in the comic, like the old comics,
yeah,
Silver Age comics, and they were just like, "No, it's un-American to hate anyone who's American or something, you know, something like that." No, I mean it might make him uncomfortable, but he wouldn't give a shit, you know, because that's America. Captain America. Oh yeah, I saw that. Who cares? It's not going to last. It's not. It's a new Captain America book. Whatever. D13.
Nothing in the comics lasts.
Nothing. Nothing. Nothing matters. Do you guys know that? Nothing matters.
D6. What are they doing with him in the comics? Because I'm not.
He just had a new comic book come out, like a new like Captain America, Steve Rogers. And as it turns out, he's an agent of Hydra. He's been an agent of Hydra this whole time.
Oh yeah, that's gonna stick, and that's exactly what's happening.
Yep.
It's not part of some kind of either mind control plot or infiltration. It's neither of those two things.
Nope. He was definitely an agent of Hydra this whole time. Right, great.
I never watched the Agent Carter TV show because I've rarely ever watched TV.
I watch it. By the way.
Yeah.
Going back to Civil War for a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't think this is a huge spoiler.
It is.
Is it?
Well, it's kind of a spoiler.
Okay, then I won't say it. I watched the Agent Carter TV show. I liked it. You know what it was? It was sassy.
Mm-hmm.
We get the Stark, Howard Stark's butler teaming up with Agent Carter. Jarvis, Howard Stark's butler, is like a prim.
Oh dear.
A prim and proper British gentleman teaming up with Agent Peggy Carter to like solve mysteries and do spy shit. It was awesome. It was awesome and sassy, and I was really upset to hear that they are not making any more Agent Carters.
Is Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. still on?
It is, and it's awful.
But Agent Carter was good, and that's canceled.
Yes.
Well, there's no justice in this world, Jack.
Oh, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. is so terrible. I'm about to spoil this season of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Mm-hmm.
I want you guys to all know that. No one watches it, so I don't think anyone will care. But for the next 3 minutes, I'm going to spoil the shit out of the season finale of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Okay.
Or the last episode. I don't know if it was the season finale. They were touting up, what's her name? Daisy, the main character, an inhuman who works for S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah.
Had a vision of the future,
mm-hmm,
because another inhuman gave her power to see the future. And she saw in it was a S.H.I.E.L.D. logo on a jacket in a spaceship in space with blood. And so it was an agent of S.H.I.E.L.D. is going to die. Mm-hmm. Which agent is going to die? That was the all season, right?
Yeah.
It was huge. Here it is. Major spoiler. If you haven't seen it, stop watching now. They made a slightly minor character an agent that episode, and that character died.
That episode,
they made him an agent.
Well, that is the lamest thing you could do.
And you knew exactly who it was at the beginning of the season. It's going to be this. It was like a love interest of Daisy's, another Inhuman who had a bit of a temper, a bit of a wild card. He was in and out of all the seasons.
Uh-huh.
They made him an agent that episode. He sacrifices himself and dies. It's like, bull fucking shit episode. It's garbage. That show is so garbage.
Oh, my God.
It's such a shame because I love Agent Coulson as a character, and that show has absolutely ruined him as a character. I can't even, like, see him as a cool guy anymore.
Do you know who Jim Shooter is?
Jim Schooner?
Shooter.
Shooter?
He was for a while, he was the editor-in-chief at Marvel. He's also a comic book writer.
Okay.
He wrote his first comic book when he was 14. He sent it into DC, and they liked it. They took his story.
Oh.
But he wrote when he was 14. He wrote like a couple issues of I think it was the Legion of Superheroes.
Okay,
where he introduced a new character, and then the very next issue killed him off.
Why?
Because kids were reading comic books at the time, and when they saw this new character, they took him in as part of the team. And then when he died, it was like, oh no, they killed off so and so that was just introduced.
Oh.
Jim Shooter.
Shooter.
Yeah, he also ran Valiant for a while before they kicked him out. He had a habit of getting a high position in comic book companies and then being ousted.
Oh. I mean, was he bad?
No, he was great. Marvel Universe as a universe was great when he was in charge of it.
Oh, well then. Oh, we got Ethan here, so we can... Control R.
Valiant, when he was starting Valiant, was great. Where characters could die and everything.
Can you lottery me? Lottery me.
Subs.
Sure.
We're doing subs this time.
Sure.
Subs and mods. Gobbledygooks.
Gobbledygooks. Gobbledygooks. Okay. I'm ready.
Lucas here.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Gobbled.
Did I ever talk about what a prick Jay is?
E.
He's such a prick.
Wait, how do you spell gooks?
G-O-O-K-S, I think.
J-Bimman?
J-Bimman, I think that's his name.
Javis Bimman is kind of a joke. Do you know that about him?
Yeah.
It's like a huge joke. Sorry. I can only type in gobbledygoo. So you're now gobbledygoo. Ethan. Ethan is gobbledygook. And actually, you know what? I'm going to leave you off of this mission. I'm really sorry. But what do I got here? I just never use teleport, so I'm...
We're putting up some soundproofing around the new set today. Jay made me do all of the work. He just sat down. He didn't do anything.
Oh, what a jerk. What a terrible jerk.
Hang all these things from the ceiling. Uh-huh. He didn't do it. Not a thing. Not a thing. Okay, obviously, I'm kidding.
Obviously.
Just because you know, you never underestimate an idiot is what I've learned in life.
Uh-huh.
I am just kidding.
It's quite possible that when we did the randomization, we noticed that Jay was watching.
It's possible.
It's very possible. It's possible. And so we just wanted to poke at him a little bit. Get rid of you. Okay, great. And so now we're done with this system. We've explored all the ships in the system.
Oh my god.
So now we have to go to the galaxy. This is the galaxy view.
Yep. I'm assuming that takes a ton of fuel.
Well, these are so there's propulsion and then there's jumps.
Okay.
So we have three jumps. Let's see here. And then we can zoom in on the system. So that has some ships. And some fuel deports, that's good. Let's see what's in here. This is like a store. So it has like a trade post. Maybe I'll do that one.
Just out of curiosity, chat, are there really people that think the Plinketto board is trashed and we're never going to use it again because it's not in every episode now?
Mm-hmm. I'm sure.
So I don't know if the people would say things like that. Like they got rid of the Plinketto board. I don't know if they're just kidding. I hope they're just kidding. But I'm never, like I said, never underestimate an idiot.
Yeah, it's true.
Trap. Another shield. Oh, there's nothing really good. Nothing really good in the store. That's all right. All right. Never underestimate an idiot. Okay, great. Let's go there. And let's board. Enter. Here we go. Here we go. What? No, just looking at the chat. Oh, here we get a little bit of story.
Fixed the food replicator on B-Wing. Just a hiccup in the communicator. Firing crazy signal to the modular assemblers. No problem now, though. Made myself up an amazing slice of lemon meringue before little fellows are firing on all cylinders again. Doubt anybody will complain. As fine as that pie. I'll fire a report out to Leland when I get back up to engineering. Let them ooh their babies are all good. And see, then your computer automatically links different theories together.
Okay.
So, just neat stuff. Little into it.
What is the name of this horrible game? Somebody wants to know.
This is Duskers, and I am far too into it. It's about exploring ships using only drones. You can only type in commands into a console. What do you call that when you type in commands?
Just command line prompt. Command prompts.
Command prompts. It's incredibly and like unexplainably engaging is what I will say. It's a whole different kind of game. If you want a different kind of game, this is your thing.
Have we seen the new Star Trek show teaser? When would you like it to be set? Pre-original, post-TNG, in between?
Didn't they already do a pre-original?
I haven't seen a teaser, if there is one. As far as when I would like to be set, none of the above is fine. If it's almost, you know, even if it's a reboot, I don't give a shit. What? Why do you laugh?
Because that's such a Rich Evans thing to say.
What?
Huh?
Why? What's wrong with that?
Because you're a grumpy old man, and I think it's funny.
No, wait. How does this correlate with being a grumpy old man?
My Star Trek is my Star Trek. I just want it to be a new Star Trek. That's how it's coming across.
A grumpy old man would be, I want it to be like the one I like.
Can't
send it in the TNG era. Don't deviate from that formula.
First of all, that would be great.
I'm saying just, you know, it's okay to wipe the slate clean and do it from scratch. That's what I'm saying. That's the young hip guy thing to say.
What?
Or the midlife crisis thing to say. Maybe I'm having a midlife crisis. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Rich is having a midlife crisis.
As far as Duskers.
Duskers.
I think this is enjoyable, but my mindset is all doom.
Oh, yeah.
And this game has given me whiplash.
Yeah, coming from Doom.
Yeah.
This was a downshift. This was personally this was a downshift that I needed after Doom. I just needed to like a game that I could not with Doom. A part that I cut out of the episode is me explaining how after every chapter of Doom, I had to pry my fingers off of the controller because I was so into Doom. And so I just wanted a light game.
I'm going to get caught up in tips here.
Get it caught up, Rich!
Local Catbug says, just joined, as we are kind of already addressed this. Sorry if you've discussed it already. Have you seen the teaser for the new Star Trek show?
That's perfect.
He's the one who asked in the chat.
Too. Oh, great.
If you have, what era would you like to see the show take place in? Yeah. So ironically, I already read that. One Small Ball says, hey, Rich, do you ever receive the very meaty, juicy shirt I sent you? Love the stream, fellas. Mostly because of Rich, though. I have. That's all I'm going to say for right now. I have plans for it. I have plans for the T-shirt, One Small Ball.
Oh, there's plans.
Minor ones. Don't get your hopes too up.
They were up.
But I have a plan for it. It has a destiny. Anonymous says,
A destiny.
This game needs more murder. And demons. And loading barrels. And a better theme song. Fuck yeah. Jack, do you want to serenade everybody?
Oh god, I can't. You can't put me on like for Duskers.
No, oh, I was gonna just the Doom one again, but.
Oh, I thought you wanted me to make a Dusker song, after Phoenix Wright. It might be musicaled out.
You don't have to. I'm sorry for putting you on the spot.
No, Duskers gets no theme song. I'm sure everyone has noticed. Duskers has no music. It only has, like, the beeps, the bloops, and the slight humming from all of your drones.
Mm-hmm.
And one time I tried playing and I put some music on in the background, and I hated it. It ruined the experience for me. I only want to hear the bleeps, the bloops.
I noticed our scans have never detected a human corpse. I'm assuming that's significant.
Maybe. I don't know. Here's something fun that after reading the manual, I read the manual. I printed out the manual and read the manual, which I think is great because it looks like it came out of a dot matrix printer.
Mm-hmm.
You can use a semicolon in between commands to make a chain. And so right now I want three to go to R3 and interface. And so navigate three to R3 and then interface.
Okay.
And then he'll go there and interface once he's there. And it's just adorable. Make the thing move. And now he's going to hit face. Oh, good. A defense. Well, sure. Let's see what we can... let's see what we can kill. Oh, no powered defense turrets found. Shit.
TNG After Dark says... Hey guys, did either of you hear about the horrible shaming of Jack and Josh in the SoundCloud version of Review?
The shaming?
Shaming. I have no idea because I've not heard it.
Did Jay and Mike shame us? They would never do that.
Have you ever said anything bad about Tremors?
I have only said good things about Tremors.
Okay.
Tremors is an amazing movie.
I just assumed after reading that you had like a negative opinion about Tremors, but
Tremors is an amazing movie. And I just don't believe you. I can't imagine a world in which Jay and Mike would make fun of their friends. I think that would be incomprehensible. I wouldn't believe it at all.
I know you're listening, Jay. What'd you say?
I'm sure it's fine.
They said they would have an episode of Jack and Josh, and it would be the lowest viewed episode ever.
Well, that's not shaming. That's probably just true.
That's not shaming.
That's you. Oh, you mean that? You mean Jay and Mike said a correct thing?
Yonder says, oh, wait, I missed one here. Tired and Sad says, Civil War was overall well made. Downey Jr.'s performance again was the highlight of the film, but the actor playing Bucky/Winter Soldier is neither sympathetic or interesting. I agree with the second part. I agree that Robert Downey Jr. had a good performance, but just, it wasn't a very fun Tony Stark. Obviously, what they were doing with the character, there was a lot of angst going on, and it was appropriate angst for the story. But I'd rather just watch Iron Man 1 again, when he was snarky and fun and kind of an ass. And not kind of frazzled and depressed. I would prefer rewatching Iron Man.
You know, I think you need the ebbs and flows, Rich. You need a frazzled and depressed Iron Man so he can come out of his funk.
I'm sure fit into the universe. This is a landmark, necessary film, but
yeah.
I don't know that I'd ever want to watch it on my own again. Yonder says, why did no one point out that the government's response to the invasion of New York was to nuke the frigging city?
That's what you get. That's what you get with a council, by the way.
Nobody... is above the law. What you're doing by saying Iron Man and Captain America and friends can do whatever they want all of the time.
I'm not saying they can do whatever they want all the time. I'm saying
Oh, shit. Run away! Run away!
What's going on?
An airlock burst in that room.
Uh-huh.
And now it's filling the ship with radiation.
Oh.
So we are running away.
Anonymous says, Rich, I've been down lately, and nothing has compelled me to keep fighting more than your epic tree balls battle.
Tree balls battle?
I'm reading that again just because it sounds so weird. Nothing has compelled me to keep fighting more than your epic tree balls battle. True greatness comes not from never getting hit, but never staying the fuck down. You're welcome, but what is the tree balls battle?
What could autocorrect into tree balls?
Oh, Bloodborne! Not Bloodborne, Dark Souls 3.
Oh, God. Tree balls!
Tree balls! Tree balls!
That was... Oh, I almost forgot about tree balls. Good old tree balls.
I'm glad to have helped. Anonymous says, Jack and Rich, I'll have you know that there is a growing community of hypnosis fetishists online, and we don't appreciate your what is this? Kink shaming hat frauds. First of all, we're not talking about a kink shared between consenting adults.
What was that?
Talking about a tutorial video on how to circumvent consent.
Consenting adults, that's the real key.
Yes.
That's the real key to this. you want to pretend like you're hypnotized? Oh, great. That's your thing. There's weirder stuff out there. Yeah, you want to pretend you're hypnotized?
Or somebody who agrees ahead of time. Yeah, hypnotize me and we'll have sex.
Sure. You know, hypnotize me and we'll have sex.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like they know they're going to have sex before they're hypnotized? Sure. Sure. Do you do, man? Do you do?
There was a lot of rape in that last Best of the Worst. Here's the thing.
Yeah.
We don't like screen the movies ahead of time.
Right.
And the wheel is random chance.
Yep.
It just worked out that way, sadly.
Yep. Yep. Unfortunately, it happens sometimes. Okay, hold on. The sequence of events simply doesn't add up. Moment from loss of contact, and nothing suggests there was a disturbance in space-time. Whoever wrote this report are only seeing things that they want to see. The objective truth is that readings present an element of specificity that is not often found in nature. They a pattern. First, loss of communication, then loss of location will require further military investigation. Beep. Bleep. Bleep. Beep, beep. And you haven't seen Deadpool yet, right?
No, I need to. I know I need to, and I know it's available now.
You do need to.
It comes up like during streams or when I'm at the studio talking to Jay or Mike.
Yeah.
Seen oh yeah, I need to say that I get home. By the time I get home, I've forgotten about the conversation, and I forget to get a copy of Deadpool.
Ah,
this is what's happened.
Gotcha.
Kind of like with Dread, because I fully intended to watch that for a while. Yeah, I'll watch Dread. I got home and I'm just not thinking about it.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
And while the revenge video chat was also kind of morally reprehensible.
Yeah.
It doesn't have the creep factor.
Oh, yeah.
Rape's got a creep factor that mail fraud doesn't. Though they're both illegal.
Rich, understatement of the year. Understatement of the goddamn year.
See, but apparently it needed to be stated is the problem. One of those is kind of more disgusting than the other.
Right. But
they're both bad. Thrombus the Gorlock says, I enjoyed what they did with Tony Stark in Civil War. I prefer they shake his character up a bit before he gets stale. rather than waiting for him to get stale and then shaking him up.
Ha-ha!
I'd rather have as many enjoyable appearances with that character before Robert Downey Jr. just stops doing it altogether. This is what I'd rather, but then, you know, it's just me. I know everyone loves Civil War. I'm the outlier. That's fine. That's fine. Everyone likes what they like, and that's fine.
No, and, like, to me, it's all a focus issue. It's all a focus issue. If we would have had Avengers Civil War,
mm-hmm.
we could have had, like, he wouldn't need to be morose because of certain spoilers that needed to happen because of the Captain America Winter Soldier Part 2.
Mm-hmm.
And it could have been fun, Tony Stark.
You know what? I don't care. I just don't care that much.
Perfect.
Tyron says, hey, guys, I got to meet Max Landis over the weekend. I used to think his attitude was obnoxious on camera, but in person he was a genuinely great guy. Also, where do you want X-Men to go after Singer? Just make another Deadpool, because apparently that's a really good film.
Deadpool's great.
Just make another Deadpool. I don't care about the X-Men.
You need... X-Men needs... What? Already? Oh.
You know how many issues of the X-Men I've read?
I know. You're not an X-Men guy.
Zero.
I'm a...
Zero issues.
I'm an X-Men guy. You need a director who can handle an ensemble.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a big problem there because not many directors can. Who can do that and give us good action sequences?
What do you do story wise?
For the next X-Men?
Yeah.
That's a good question.
They've already dragged out all of the big guns, haven't they?
Yeah.
Days of Future Past, Apocalypse.
All of the government
kind of laws, Sentinel mm-hmm. kind of stuff. They did that sure. in X-Men 2.
Yep. You know, they had a really fun storyline in Ultimate X-Men, in which many of the mutants got captured
mm-hmm.
By the Weapon X. Okay. You know what? I'm just going to pause it.
Yep.
Stuff can happen to your ship while you're not doing stuff.
That sounds bad.
A bunch of mutants got captured by the Weapon X program.
Yeah.
And they were forced to be mercenaries, a bunch of the X-Men. And so that's your story.
Okay.
Because we already have established mutant characters. People know who they are already.
Yeah.
They get kidnapped and forced into mercenary work, and the story is them freeing themselves and possibly stopping some sort of bad thing from happening that maybe they were assigned to make happen badly or whatnot.
Okay.
That could be a fun story.
Okay.
It's simple. We don't, it doesn't, not everything needs to be Save the Universe. Simple.
Can you do the age of what was the one where time, the big storyline they had where time got rewritten? The Age of Apocalypse? Was that what that was called? The Age of something?
The Phalanx?
I know they did a big storyline. It was the only other major X-Men storyline I could think of. The Age of something where time got reset. Everything was different. for 3 months of comic time before it got undone. Like, Professor X was, I think, assassinated in the past, and that changed history.
Sure.
What was that called? Was that the Age of Apocalypse?
No, that's Days of Future Past, isn't it?
Age of Apocalypse, yes, Rich. Okay.
Well, the real van, of course it sounds kind of generic. You build, that's the framework. The story is the framework. Then you get some nice character moments, you get some other stuff. We need some simple stories.
Is the X-Men cinematic universe? Not that there really is a... not that there's really an X-Men cinematic universe yet. I mean, I guess they've all just been X-Men sequels. Is it big enough for, like, an Age of Apocalypse? Because that's the only other big X-Men story that I can think of.
We don't need a big X-Men story. We need a small X2 was a fine movie because it was simple.
Great, then they already did it. We don't need to make more. That's my stance. That's where I'm coming. That's where I'm coming down on this.
Sure.
They've done it. They're done. They're done. But that will never fly anymore.
Nope.
You can't just say, we're done. We did it. We did that movie. No, you got to keep cranking out that franchise. Turn that franchise crank.
Yep.
Nico Cola says, hey guys, 2016 is already almost half over.
Is that true?
Sure. Life is depressing. What movie are you most looking forward to the rest of this year? None, apparently. We kind of talked about it earlier. There's nothing that I can think of exciting coming up. Gobbledygook says, any thoughts on new Xbox One and PS4? Thinking of getting an NVIDIA GTX 1800? Or a 1080, not 1800, sorry. Specs look really good. Do you ever worry about future games that won't play well? And DC Universe Online is still free, you fucks.
Thanks for letting us know. The big announcement in the console world is Xbox One is announcing future, not Xbox Two.
Yeah.
Upgrades to Xbox One. Xbox One with more powerful internal components and slimmer designs. So basically what people would do to their PC, like swapping out one piece and putting in another piece. But it's a whole new Xbox.
My brain is calculating. Is this going to replace having a future... Is this going to replace ever having an Xbox 2?
Maybe.
Is this going to be, from here on out, upgradable consoles, is the question? Right? Is that...
No, but they're not upgrading it. They're selling a whole new console. You can't upgrade your console.
But, I mean, instead of ever having an Xbox 2, is it just going to be like a blur? And then is that going to eventually lead to... Is that going to eventually lead to confusion on who can play what on what?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, you need an Xbox One Mark II.
So even though I'm a PC elitist,
yes,
this is another example of a console taking on some of the worser aspects of PC gaming.
Yes.
Where there's always an issue with like what are my specs?
Wait, what's the recommended settings?
Yeah.
What's the optimal setting?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. So by the way, that whole argument about like, oh, you get a console because it's easy. You put something in and it plays, gone.
Yeah.
Gone.
As far as me worrying about that kind of stuff on my current PC, I think my PC is decent enough where I have a fair amount of future proofing.
Yeah, we're going to get you some more RAM.
Yeah, I need some more RAM.
Yeah, we'll get you some more, yeah.
I think I'm good for a while. I'm playing Doom on Ultra, and I know a lot of people are having issues with that.
You're playing Doom on Ultra?
Yeah.
Nice. Nice, Rich.
I met all of the recommended specs for that game. Not Quantum Break. What a fucking joke. Ethan Mage says, you guys mentioned a crowd being silent, maybe due to pass-through being more sane. No, it's something else. That's all I could say. Also, how will RLM see Breen Lesson 4? DVD or theater? Didn't we? We brought that comment up earlier. He sent it again. Maybe he didn't hear it when we brought it up earlier. Okay. Like, I haven't seen Pass Through. I don't have any real thoughts on it.
Yep. I mean,
as far as theater, I haven't heard about any theater ones. We'll probably end up seeing it in DVD.
Probably. Just because, Milwaukee isn't usually high on the list for smaller showings.
Well, it's his fourth movie, right? Pass Through? Fourth or third? I think it's his fourth. We've only seen the one. We've only seen Double Down.
There's Double Down. There's I Am Here Now.
Mm-hmm.
There's another one. So Pass Through might be his fourth, yeah.
We're still in Lesson 1. I'm not... There's no rush.
No.
There's no rush.
No rush.
Michael Cody, CA, says, are you guys doing to do anything with Nuki tapes? Also... Whatever happened to that box in the one best of the worst you guys opened? Nuki tapes, you know what? Fuck it. We need a few more. That is so old. That is so old.
We just need a few more, guys.
That joke ran out of gas a year ago.
We just need a few more.
Fumes.
Nuki tapes.
The Nuki joke's running on fumes.
Why do you think we need more tapes?
I tried to reinvigorate it like a month or two ago, but I came up by like implying that we're building some kind of mecha suit out of Nuki tapes.
By the way, Jay makes a very good point. If we saw Pass Through in the theater, we wouldn't be able to record our reactions.
That's true.
For
yeah.
it.
Yeah, we're almost certainly going to watch that on DVD. Is he actually having a theatrical release? I'm very confused. Yeah?
Wow. Yes. He's an insane person, Rich.
Wow.
Yeah.
And the box was full of some guys made like Eloise Cole themed like props.
Oh, fun.
Eloise Cole, the
Grief clown.
The grief clown, who he implied was some kind of death goddess. And he made like Lovecraftian kind of like tablets they found for Eloise Cole, all kind of stuff. Telegon says, Jack, thanks for the feedback on my film. Just want to know one thing, is it worse than Things?
Nothing is worse than Things. I did finally watch the student film adaptation or the adaptation for the class. Gave some notes. Look into that book. Great book.
I haven't seen your thing, but Things is the worst.
Things is the worst.
It's just the worst.
Yours wasn't as bad as Things because it wasn't as long as Things. It wasn't a good short, but like I said, look into that that cinematography book that I mentioned. Really great resource for kind of the fundamentals of setting up shots and editing, and it's great. It's a great little book.
TNG After Dark says, are you for sure waiting for Max to watch Pass-Through, or will you just eventually watch it? I don't know that we're waiting on Max. Not that I'm against watching it with Max, but I mean, we'll get to it when we get to it. I don't know.
He lives in Los Angeles.
He lives in Los Angeles.
It's not like he can just come over and hang out on a moment's notice.
It's the reason Jillian hasn't been back.
You know, there's just things, people. We don't know. We don't do everything all the time for everybody all the time. What?
What? I am going to stand up.
Oh my God, you're probably right. Yep. What? Oh. Navigate to navigate. Who do I want? Navigate 3 to R2 semicolon interface. Go. Fucking damn it. Navigate 3 2 R3 semicolon interface. Why is it saying R2? Navigate 3 2 R3. Oh, interface. Felt like I was taking crazy pills. I can do a ship, scan. All right. I'm gonna stand up. It's time to stand up. I can't believe I've been sitting for so long. This is how I get very engaged in this game, and it might not look like it's the most exciting thing in the world. But like any good horror movie, because you can't see everything, it's incredibly engaging. You're most scared of the monsters you can't see, and that's all this game is you not seeing stuff. It's crazy.